Okay, salam alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Okay, kita sambung balik on our tutorial, which is tutorial 4. Okay, kita boleh teruskan dengan tutorial 4. Silakan.
I'll start number 1, sir.
Alright.
Can you see my slide, sir?
Yes.
Okay. So the question is, choose the correct statement related to work done on an object. So my answer is B, which is 1, 3, and 4. 1, the product of force acting on the object and the magnitude of the displacement. 3, the unit of work is in joule, J, newton meter, kgm square over s square. And work is a scalar quantity because it is a resultant from a dot product of force and displacement.
Okay, siapa nombor dua salah?
Sebab dia cakap work done on an object moving with a constant force and directed perpendicularly. Kan patutnya parallel.
Okay. Component of force parallel to the displacement. Alright. Next. Thank you.
Miss it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so the question number 2, work done equals to the change in A, kinetic energy, B, momentum, C, direction, and D, location. So the answer is A, kinetic energy.
Okay, kenapa?
Because work and energy, the work energy theorem states that the net work done on an object of mass is equal to the change in kinetic energy.
Yes. Work energy theorem. Itu keyword dia. Next. Good.
So boleh saya baca je soalan dia?
Boleh.
Alright, number 3. When a person drops off a plank into a pool, y equals to 0, is located on the water surface, saya jawab B. Kinetic energy is highest as the person reach the water surface.
Okay, kenapa tak jawapan lain?
Kalau A, kinetic energy transform to potential energy, supposedly potential energy transform to kinetic energy.
Okay.
Untuk C, potential energy is zero at the starting point. No, potential energy is the highest at the starting point. For D, potential energy increases, kinetic energy decreases. This one may be correct if dia stay dekat situ at the starting point, I think.
Okay, tapi basically kalau dekat starting point pun, dia tak dekat, dia tak jadi macam tu sebab kinetic energy memang kosong kalau dekat starting point. Kalau dekat starting point, tapi dia sepatutnya dia daripada potential energy PE akan jadi decrease. KE akan increase, terbalik.
Okay.
Okay, next. Thank you, very good. Number 4.
Me, sir.
Yep, silakan.
Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, the question is, power is defined as work done, blank space, by time interval or the rate at which energy transferred. I answer C divide, because the question said the rate at which energy transferred. Kalau rate dia over time, so calculus the formula is P equals to E over T. So energy is ability to supply or create work. So boleh juga tulis W over T. And also the as a unit of power is joules per second. Joules tu sama dengan work. So sebab tu saya answer divide.
Tepat. Okay, penerangan pun baik. Terima kasih. Okay, jelas. Semua orang faham ya. Ada P equals to, biasanya kita pakai P equals to W per T. Tapi pada masa yang sama, kita kena faham juga yang kadang-kadang dia tak mention W, dia mention E. P equals to E per T pun boleh. Sebab E dengan W share the same unit, which is joule. Okay. Okay, next structure questions.
Yes.
Yep, silakan.
Can you see my screen, sir?
Not yet.
Yes.
Tak keluar. Pada pandangan saya tak keluar lagi. Yeah. Cuba pilih screen kamu yang kamu nak pilih. Yep. Okay. Nampak.
Dah.
Nampak.
Okay. So.
Yeah. Sekarang dah nampak. Question.
Okay. So the question is, a horizontal force of 150 Newton is used to push a 40 kg packing crate of a distance of 6 meter on a rough horizontal surface. If the crate moves at constant speed, find A, the work done by the 150 and force. So, mula saya listkan dulu dia punya information. Equals to 150 N, M is 40 kg, and displacement is 6 meter. So, mula-mula dia suruh cari the work done by the 150 and force. So, tahu dia punya work done is equals to force times displacement. So, saya masukkan 150N times dengan 6 meter dapat 900 joule. Okay. Untuk B pula, dia letak the coefficient of kinetic friction between the crate and the surface. So, mula-mula dekat soalan ni dia kata the crate moves at constant speed. Maksudnya, acceleration is zero. So, kita tahu submission of F is equal to MA. So, since A is zero, so submission of F is zero. So kita tengok in X direction. So F minus frictional force equals to MA. So since A is zero, so F minus frictional force is zero. So kita tahu yang frictional force ni is mu K and times normal force. So kita tengok dia nak cari frictional force, kita tengok dekat dia punya Y direction. So N minus MG is equals to zero since the box is not moving in Y direction. So saya masukkan N minus 40 times 9.8 akan dapat normal force dia akan dapat 392. So dapat N dia, kita masukkan balik dalam the first equation F minus frictional force. Kita akan dapat coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.383.
Okay. Okay, untuk nombor ni, macam soalan 4A. Saya rasa tak ada masalah pun jangan kira kamu ni. Very, very good. Cuma, cuba amalkan. Kalau W work equals to FD, jangan tulis FD saja. Tulis FD cos theta. FD cos theta. So, theta dia 0. Then, value dia akan dapat FD cos theta, theta 0, so dapatlah 900. Biasakan dengan macam tu sebab dalam situasi dia nanti mungkin akan ada theta. Macam contoh dia soalan nombor 2, nanti kan ada theta. Okay. Lepas tu untuk soalan nombor B, saya rasa tidak ada masalah sebab cuma kalau dekat N tolak MG sama dengan kosong tu, letakkan dia submission of FX dan FY sama dengan kosong. Barulah tulis N tolak MG sama dengan kosong, N sama dengan MG. MG value dia berapa macam tu. Okay. Lepas tu dekat bawah tu F tolak mu KN tu kamu gunakan submission of FX equals to MA. Fx equals to MA. So 150 tolak dengan mu k kali dengan n sama dengan kosong. Mu k bla 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 bla. Sekian macam tu. Okay, next. Sir. Okay.
Saya, sir.
Yep, silakan.
Nampak tak, sir?
Ya, yeah, nampak.
Okay, so question 2. A block of mass M equals to 2.5 kilogram is pushed a distance D, 2.2 meter, along a frictionless horizontal table by a constant applied force of a magnitude 60 Newton directed at an angle 25 degree below the horizontal as shown in figure. Determine the work done by A, the applied force. So first I sketch the free body diagram. So from the applied force is 60 Newton. So saya extract to X and Y component. So this is the X component and this is the Y component. So then work done by the applied force. So we know that work is equal to Fd cos theta. So F is 60 Newton, D is 2.2, and cos theta is 25 degree. So the answer is 31.9 joules. As for B, the normal force exerted by the table. So we know that this is the normal force. This is the displacement of the block, so it is perpendicular to the movement. So kita substitute balik the value into this equation Fd cos theta. So n d 2.2 cos 90 degree. So we know that cos 90 degree is 0, so the answer is 0 joule. Untuk C pula sama je macam B ni, kita substitute balik the force of gravity, so mg 2.2 cos 90, cos 90 is also 0, so wg is equals to 0 joule. D pula, the net force on the block, so kita nak tahu net force on the block, so we have to total semua work done by the block, so 31.9 plus 0 plus 0, 0 and 0 is from these two. And then we know that this is frictionless, so tak ada frictional work tak ada work done by the friction. So W is equal to 31.9 joules.
Okay, very good. Saya suka, cuma dekat macam biasalah. Saya kan selalu jenis kalau lukis free body diagram tu memang tak boleh tengok kalau force tu masuk ke dalam sistem. Tapi kamu faham, tak apa. Okay, cuma kalau next time kalau sketch tu free body diagram tu, make sure force dia keluar. Okay, sama je jawapan dia. Jadi kamu nampak, okay, N memang kat atas, MG memang kat bawah. Sebab sepatutnya free body diagram, all arrows mesti pointing outward, keluar. Outward, tak boleh pointing into the Cartesian coordinates. Dan sekarang ni, F tu dia points ke dalam kan. Kita nak dia keluar, maknanya kamu teruskan F tu ke bawah. Theta dia antara Fx dengan F. Barulah dia boleh jadi, dia punya, baru kita boleh nampak. Dalam situasi ni dia suruh cari work. So tidak ada kaitan dengan force. Adalah kaitan tapi tak ada kaitan dengan nak cari friction ke whatever. So in this case, okay eh. Tak ada masalah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you sir.
Next, number 3. Soalan pendek-pendek yang ini. InsyaAllah kalau boleh settle cepat, settle cepat.
Yes sir. Sir, can you see the screen?
Yes.
Question states that during a penalty kick, a soccer player kicks a 0.440 kg soccer ball at 29 meters per second. At what speed must a tennis player hit a 0.0580 kg tennis ball so that the two balls have the same kinetic energy? In the question, it states that both balls have the same energy. It's just terms of finding the velocity, so that means 1 over 2 m1 v1 square equals to 1 over 2 m2 v2 square, and I make v2 subject the velocity of the tennis ball as the subject while moving the numbers to the right hand side, and I get 79.9 meters per second.
Okay, very good. Darwish, thank you. Okay, so dalam situasi ni, kinetic energy sama. So dia boleh buat kiri sama dengan kanan. So half-half tu semua boleh potong. Okay, next, number 4.
Me, sir.
Okay.
The question is, HMS Titanic had a mass of 4.75 times 10 power of 7 kg and a cruising speed of 10.7 meter per second. First question is, cari kinetic energy dia. So saya guna formula 1 over 2 mv square. Masukkan nilai dia dapat 2.72 darab 10 kuasa 9 joule. Lepas tu yang B, disuruh calculate the work required to stop. So saya buat force yang sama tapi arah yang berbeza, sebab tu saya letak negatif. Lepas tu yang C pula, determine the magnitude of the constant force that could bring it to the rest in 2.5 kilometer. So saya cari dia punya force, masukkan nilai, pindahkan dan saya dapat 1.09 darab 10 kuasa 6 newton.
Okay, untuk yang part B tu, yang part B tu sepatutnya kena gunakan work energy theorem. W equals to delta KE. Delta KE maksudnya KE final tolak KE initial. Cuma dalam case ni, the work required to stop it, dia tak boleh simply kita letak negatif macam tu je. Kita kena cakap, okay, the work required, maksud kena calculate kinetic energy final tolak kinetic energy initial. Cuma dalam case, untuk stop, kinetic energy final kena zero. So, kosong tolak 2.72 kali 10 kuasa 9. Dapatlah negatif 2.72 kali 10 kuasa 9 joule. Okay, faham eh?
Faham, thank
okay.
you sir.
Okay, good. Next.
Saya sir?
Yap, yap, silakan.
Okay. Sir, kan nampak?
Nampak-nampak.
Alright. So, number 5. Kita tengok soalan dulu. Dia cakap, a 0.20 kg stone is held 1.3 meter above the top edge of a water well and then drop into it. So, the well has a depth of 5.0 meter. Taking Y is 0 at the top edge of the well. What is the gravitational potential energy of the stone earth? So memang dia tahu, kita tahu dia nak PE. So first dia cakap before the stone is released. Jadi saya lukis yang ni well dia, and then dia cakap Y is equal to 0 at the above ni. Jadi Okay. Jadi dan yang A dia cakap before the stone is released. So saya buat PE is equals to MGY, dia punya formula. So before release, kita tahu dia punya height dia adalah 1.3 meter. So kita masukkan Y dia and then mass dia and then dia punya gravity negative 9.8. So dia akan dapat negative 2.5 joule. And then for B, dia cakap when it reaches the bottom of the well. So bila it reaches the bottom of the well, kita buat benda yang sama, yang ni sama. So masukkan. And masukkan juga, kita akan dapat negative 9.8 joule. And then for C, dia cakap what is the change in gravitational potential energy of the system from release to reaching the bottom of the well. So saya buat the change of PE. PE final dengan PE initial. Final dia dekat yang ni, this one. and the initialnya this one. So saya tolakkan, saya akan dapat 12.3 joule.
Okay, untuk part A, macam mana cakap? Okay, dapat negative 2.5 based on equation MGY. Tapi sebenarnya G tu memang dia tidak boleh jadi negative 9.8. G tu kena 9.8. Sebab nilai G 9.8. Biasanya kita buat negative 9.8 ni A. So bila macam tu, so sepatutnya jawapan dia mesti dapat 0.2 kali 9.8 kali 1.3. So sepatutnya jawapan dia tu kena positif, I think. Kena positif. Positif 2.5 joule. Okay, positif 2.5 joule. Okay, sebab G memang 9.8. Macam cakap dalam kes bola apa, ball in the air lah. Okay, sebelum dia jatuh dalam well tu, ball in the air lah kan. So G dia memang 9.8. Sama juga dengan soalan B. Soalan B, G dia masih masih lagi 9.8. Sebab dia tak jatuh dalam air kan. G masih lagi 9.8. Tetapi dia punya apa, Y dia tu. Why dia tu? Sebab kita ambil kosong dekat top of the water well. Jadi jawab why dia tu ialah negatif 5. Sebab tu dia dapat negatif 9.8. Why tu negatif 5?
Untuk yang why dia tu, dia tak campur semua ni eh?
Tak, dia tak campur. Dia ambil, maksudnya dia ambil kita ambil based on bila dia dah tak jatuh daripada Y equals to 0.
Oh, I see.
Ke kos ke negatif 5.
Alright.
Jadi negatif 5 tolak kosong, negatif 5 lah kan. Dapat negatif 9.8. Okay. Lepas tu untuk nak calculate part C, PE, delta PE ialah PE final tolak PE initial. So PE final ialah berapa? Negatif 9.8. Negatif 9.8 ditolakkan dengan tolakkan dengan negatif 2.5. Okay, sebab kenapa negatif 2.5? Sekejap, fahamkan. Itulah, negatif 9.8 tolak dengan sepatutnya jawapan A tu 2.5 kan?
Haa, 2.5
bukan negatif kan? Patutnya jawapannya 2.5. Jadi negatif 9.8 tolak 2.5 dapatlah negatif 12. Patutnya negatif 12. Okay, tapi jawapan dalam kira kamu tidak ada masalah dari segi MGY semua tu, cuma notation tu kena betul.
Okay. Alright, thank you sir.
Okay, next.
Sekejap, saya nak tukar jadi phone sekejap. Sir, can you see sir?
Boleh.
Saya buat 1/2 MV kuasa 2 sama dengan MDH sebab saya buat potential energy sama dengan kinetic energy. So, saya masukkan nilai dia and yang kita tak tahu adalah H, H dia. Lepas so, saya dapat 0.45 meter.
Untuk jawapan ni memang betul tapi always practice eh. Kamu dah sampai satu tahap di level pusat asasi ni, di level ada level universiti. Cukup untuk pakai half mv squared sama dengan mgh. Sebab itu situasi masa zaman sekolah dulu maksud dia. Ni jawapan dia betul eh. Jawab maksud dia semua kinetic energy transfer kepada potential energy. Sebab situasi di sini, situasi di level universiti ni soalan, dia akan berbeza sebab bukan semua semua energy akan ditransfer daripada potential energy ke kinetic energy. Okay, bukan semua ditransfer macam tu. Ada juga yang dia transfer separuh je. Dia suka klik dekat separuh jalan. Ada. Okay, dia transfer ke separuh. Bila dia transfer separuh jalan, bila kamu pakai half mv squared sama dengan mgh, dia jadi salah. Sebab tu kita nak tulis apa-apa, kita kena start dengan E initial equals to E final. Gunakan energy conservation. E initial equals to E final. Maksud dia half mv squared campur dengan mgh initial equals to half mv squared campur dengan mgh final. Kena penuh. Selalu start dengan macam tu. Okay, kena selalu start dengan dua-dua equation. Sebab nanti baru kita akan, okay, yang mana akan jadi kosong, yang mana akan jadi kosong atau tak. Bila dia dah kosong, dia akan kosong lah kan. Itu yang kita boleh kata half mv squared sama dengan mgh. Kalau tak, kita tak boleh bagi tahu macam tu. Okay? Faham eh, Haris?
Faham, sir.
So anything bila nak start dengan equation, sebab tu nama dia. Kalau kita terus half mv squared equals to mgh, most probably ada certain soalan kita dapat betul. Tapi ada certain soalan kita tertinggal. Kan? Tak boleh. Contoh dia bila dia kata X. Ini kalau situasi yang kamu buat tu, half mv squared semua kinetic energy transfer kepada potential energy. Sedangkan dia boleh tanya kat mana-mana pun. Halfway sebelum jatuh dia boleh tanya. Itu persoalan-persoalan yang kita kena ni lah. Macam ni dia kata a child and a sled with a combined mass slide down on the friction. If the sled starts from rest, what is the height of the hill? Ialah soalan ni kan. And dia dah bagi tahu dekat dia start dekat mana, speed at the bottom dekat mana. Dia dah bagi tahu dah. Jadi itu bila cerita dia bila dia gerak daripada atas dan sampai bawah. Tapi kalau katalah soalan ni saya ubah, saya nak cari kat tengah-tengah. Dia dah tak boleh pakai lagi equation yang kamu tulis tu. That's why saya kata kena tulis full. Energy initial equals to energy final. Always start. Energy kena ingat. Potential energy plus kinetic energy. Itu konsep energy. Senang kan? Potential plus kinetic. Tapi untuk initial dengan final part. Okay. Okay, next.
Saya, sir.
Okay.
Okey, boleh nampak, sir?
Boleh.
Okey. Soalan dia, 0.25 kg block along a horizontal track has a speed of 1.5 meter per second immediately before colliding with a light spring of force constant 4.6 newton meter located at the end of the track. A, what is the spring's maximum compression if the track is frictionless? So, saya guna E initial equals to E final. Patut kat sini ada 1 over 2 kx initial square tapi saya lupa nak tulis. Plus with 1 over 2 mv initial square equals to 1 over 2 mv final square plus 1 over 2 kx final square. So saya masukkan nilai akan dapat 0.35 cm. Yang B pula saya terlepas pandang, tapi saya ada jawapan dia. Sebab soalan dia, if the track is not frictionless, would the sprint's maximum compression be greater than, less than or equal to the value obtained in part A? So my answer is, if the track is not frictionless, the maximum compression of the spring is less than the maximum compression of the spring on the frictionless track.
Okay, good. Okay, so kat, just ada nampak kan, equation tu dia akan jadi pelik eh. Initial, energy initial equals energy final. Tapi sebelah dia macam ada half mv squared, sebelah tak apa, sebelah sana tak ada half kx squared kan. So sepatutnya kena ada dua-dua belah lah, macam kamu cakap tadi. Okay, jadi barulah kita tahu, kita faham energy conservation macam ni. Tapi once bila awak dah tulis establish macam ni, kadang-kadang kalau jalan puan awak pun salah pun, tapi sebab kau awak tulis equation tu betul, jadi orang akan tengok. Okay, orang maybe akan boleh consider markah dekat situ. Macam tu. Kita nak cuba bagi markah semaksimum mungkin kan untuk student kita. Tapi dengan cara macam mana? Dengan cara ni kita tengok, okay, budak ni actually faham konsep energy conservation. Itu yang penting-penting. Kan, calculation is is mathematics. Tapi yang atas itu physics. Macam mana energy conservation tu? Kita boleh tulis energy, energy, energy. Itu yang penting untuk physics. Kan, macam mana kita nak keluarkan equation tu? The answers, lagi satu macam soalan B. That is also physics. Macam mana kita boleh kata dia would be less? Just kata boleh bagi less, kan? Due to friction. Friction dah dampkan dia punya motion. So, dia punya maximum compression akan jadi less. Okay?
Okay, so, thank you, sir.
Okay. Next. The two, last two questions.
Saya, sir.
Yap, silakan.
Okay, so untuk soalan nombor 8. What average mechanical power must a 70 kg mountain climber generate to climb to the summit of a hill of high 325 meters in 45 minutes. Okay, mula saya keluarkan semua maklumat yang ada. Mass dia 70 kg, high 325 meters, and time kat sini dia bagi 45 minit. Jadi saya tukar kepada unit SI, saya tukar kepada saat dan dapat 2700 saat. Kemudian dia nak power. Power pada asalnya formula dia adalah work done over time. Jadi work done saya ni saya guna formula MGY over time. Jadi saya masukkan semua maklumat ke dalam equation and dapat jawapan 82.57 watt.
Okay, so macam itulah, W per T power, tapi W juga kadang-kadang kita boleh tulis dia dalam bentuk P equals to FV, force times velocity.
Okay.
Ataupun force tu ialah WD kan, WD, W kali D per dengan T. W kali D dengan per dengan T. So W tu ialah force lah kan. Okay. Force times displacement times T. So force sama dengan MG, D sama dengan Y, per dengan T. So dapat 82.6 watt. Okay, thank you Julia. Next, you, last sir. Question.
Me sir.
Okay.
Nampak saja.
Nampak.
Soalan dia, the force acting on a particle varies as in figure. Find the work done by the force as the particle move. A from x to x 0 to 8 meter, B from x 8 meter to 10 meter, and C from x 0 to 10 meter. Soalan ni kita kena cari area under graph dia. Bagi A, 1 per 2 darab 4 darab 6 tambah 1 per 2 darab 4 darab 6
jawapan dia 24 joule. B 1/2 darab 2 darab negatif 3, jawapan dia negatif 3 joule. C 24 tambah negatif 3 sama dengan 21 joule.
Okey, untuk soalan A tu kenapa separate kan dia? 1/2 4 apa 6 tolam 0 sampai 4 atau 4 sampai 8. Kenapa separate? Kenapa tak tak calculate A yang satu?
Boleh.
Kan? 1/2 kali dengan 8 kali dengan 6. Dapat terus kan? Nah, tapi tak apalah. As long as jawapan tu still betul, jalan kira kamu faham area under the graph, itu yang paling penting lah. Okay?
Okay.
Alright. So any questions before we stop? Any questions regarding this tutorial? So kalau ikutkan midterm test sampai chapter 4 lah. Chapter 4 which is daripada tutorial 1 sampai tutorial 3 lah. Tutorial 4 ni nampak gaya dah masuk chapter 5. Okay, so chapter 5 tak adalah dalam midterm test. So kalau nak prepare daripada chapter 1 sampai daripada tutorial 1 sampai tutorial 3. Dari segi tutorial lah, dari segi chapter 1 sampai chapter 4. Okay, any questions? Ada soalan lain? Tak ada?
Tak ada, sir.
Okay, alright, so next week kita sambung dengan tutorial 5, ya? Yeah? Next week kita sambung dengan tutorial 5, insyaAllah sambung balik dengan last kali tadi lepas Muhammad Danish, ya. Kita sambung terus dengan tutorial 5. Okay, so tolong buat tutorial. Kita akan accordingly. Mungkin sekarang kita dah masuk chapter momentum. Lepas ni boleh teruskan sambung buat tutorial. Alright, thank you very much. Thank you for your attention. Kalau ada soalan, please.